Kelly Rowland currently has over 10 million followers on Instagram, and that's what you get when you are a member of one of the biggest girl groups of all time, giving us timeless songs that still get played years later. She's also had quite a successful solo career, having released 4 solo studio albums. Everyone knows her song When Love Takes Over or Motivation, and she's parlayed her fame into an acting career, having appeared in The Seat Filler, Freddy vs. Jason, and more. Having accomplished so much, it only makes sense that Kelly is living a more relaxed lifestyle since her Destiny's Child days. But that doesn't mean she's done with show business. We will break it down as this video goes on. She has, however, made time to get married to her former manager, Tim Weatherspoon, in 2014, and soon after gave birth to her little boy, Titan. So for those of you who are just starting to follow Kelly Rowland, or you wanted to know more about her lifestyle and the intimate details about her rise to fame, well, here we go. Welcome back to Famous Life. Let us know who to feature next in the comments down below. Kelly Rowland was born Calendria Trene Rowland on February 11, 1981 in Atlanta, Georgia. She is the daughter of Doris Rowland Garrison and Christopher Lovett, and she has an older brother named Orlando. When she was 6, her mother left her father, who was an abusive alcoholic due to PTSD from the Vietnam War, and Rowland went with her mom. At the age of 8, they relocated to Houston, and in 1992, Rowland joined an existing girl group originally named Girls' Time, where Rowland became the 6th member of the group. Girls' Time had been active for 2 years prior to her arrival on the scene. The original lineup consisted of Beyoncé, Robertson, Rowland, Tamar Davis, and sisters Nikki and Nina Taylor. The 6 girls competed on Star Search but lost the talent competition, leading Beyoncé's father, Matthew Knowles, to take on the role of manager to help push the group towards success. He quickly cut Davis and the Taylor sisters, adding LaToya Luckett in their place. Girls' Time eventually changed their name to Destiny. They were signed to Elektra Records, but dropped several months later before they even had a chance to release an album. In 1996, Matthews secured the foursome a deal with Columbia Records, and Destiny's Child was born. Their self-titled debut album was released in February 1998 and included the hit single No 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 Part 2. Destiny's Child released their sophomore and breakthrough album, The Writings on the Wall, in July 1999. It spawned 4 hits, Bills, 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 Bugaboo, Say My Name, and Jumpin' Jumpin'. Beyoncé announced later that year that Luckett and Robertson have left the group. They were replaced by Michelle Williams and Farrah Franklin. A much publicized battle with Matthew followed Luckett and Robertson's exits from the group. They accused him of unfairly favoring Beyoncé and Rowland and keeping more than his fair share of Destiny Child's profits. The group faced another setback when Franklin abruptly left just 5 months after joining. Now a trio, Destiny's Child released their 3rd album, Survivor, in May 2001. It became a huge success thanks to the singles Independent Women Part 1, Survivor, and Bootylicious. Shortly after Survivor's release, Rowland and Beyoncé started branching out as solo artists. Kelly collaborated with Nelly on Dilemma, while Beyoncé started spending time with a guy known as Jay-Z. Destiny's Child came together again in the studio in 2004 to record their 4th and final album, Destiny Fulfilled. This was released that November and included the singles Lose My Breath, Soldier, Girl, and Cater to You. After embarking on a world tour, the trio announced their split in 2005, saying in a statement that they wanted to leave on a high note, united in our friendship and filled with an overwhelming gratitude for our music, our fans, and each other. Beyoncé, Rowland, and Williams have only reunited on stage a few times since their breakup, most recently during Queen Bey's 2018 Coachella performance, but they've remained best friends. Rowland has released 4 solo albums, including her 2002 debut, Simply Deep, which came out while Destiny's Child were still active. Her hits include Like This, Motivation, and the David Guetta collaborations Commander and When Love Takes Over. She began dating her manager, Tim Weatherspoon, in 2011. She announced her engagement to him during an appearance on the Queen Latifah show that same year. They were married in Costa Rica on May 9, 2014, with guests including Beyoncé and Solange. That same year, she announced via Instagram that she and Weatherspoon were expecting their first child. On November 4, 2014, Rowland gave birth to their son, Titan Jewel Weatherspoon. Not one to ever slow down, Kelly branched out into acting with a guest stint on the sitcom The Hughleys back in 2002, before appearing in other UPN shows, such as Eve and Girlfriends, in the years of 2003 and 2006. In 2002, Rowland was cast for her big screen debut in the slasher film Freddy vs. Jason. Fans would remember that classic scene where she's making all those crazy insults at Freddy before. Well, I'll let you guys watch that to see what happens. The following year, Rowland returned to the big screen, this time for a lead role in the romantic comedy The Seat Filler, starring opposite Dwayne Martin and Shamar Moore. Rowland also had a supporting role in the motion picture Think Like a Man and continues to work steadily. In more recent years, Kelly's become a popular TV personality, judging The X Factor UK in 2011, The X Factor USA in 2013, and The Voice Australia since 2017. Kelly continues to stay active on social media for her 10 million Instagram followers and appears to be enjoying her best years yet while also focusing on a variety of philanthropy projects. Over the 2010s, Kelly would collaborate with a number of other artists such as Missy Elliott, Kelly Clarkson, Zendaya, Janelle Monáe, Lea Michele, and Chloe Halle. It was actually this ensemble of women who were featured on the charity single put together by none other than Michelle Obama. The song was created to generate funds for the Obama's Let Girls Learn initiative. Kelly also landed a part-time recurring role in the second season of the popular show Empire for 5 episodes. Other TV work included replacing Ronan Keating as a judge on the 6th season of The Voice Australia. In 2018, Kelly would reunite with Beyoncé and Michelle Williams for her outstanding Coachella performance, which they eventually made a Netflix program about. She was also the star of the BET series American Soul, where she portrayed none other than Gladys Knight. Kelly would also make appearances in HBO's Black Girl sketch show, as well as Beyoncé's Disney Plus exclusive Black is King. This also goes along with Kelly's new management deal that she announced with Roc Nation. In January 2021, Kelly gave birth to her second son, Noah, and when Kelly released her new EP, we saw Noah and his older brother, Titan, make appearances in the visuals. Thanks for checking out this video. Subscribe if you are new to the channel and leave a comment for who you'd like us to feature next.